In this illustration, we intend to simulate the Cobiax slab in the Abaqus software. The length and width of Cobiax slab is 4 meters and an axial force of 440 kN is applied to the Cobiax slab. In this model, the Cobiax parts are placed beside one another at a distinguished distance, then two wire meshes will be placed on the top and below the Cobiax parts, and finally the concrete pouring will be accomplished. Using Cobiax parts in the concrete slab will cause the hollow cavities to be created in the concrete slab, leading to the decrease of concrete slab weight, and so less concrete will be consumed. As you observe in this picture, the diameter of Cobiax parts are 315 millimeters. Click on Done. Here I will enter rotation angle equal to 360 degrees and OK in this manner. Here the Cobiax parts have been considered as spherical globes, the diameter of which is 315 millimeters. Then I will click on sub option, then on tension damage. I will select these two columns, copy, and paste them here. Damage parameter is a number between 0 and 1, and if the damage parameter is equal to 0, it indicates that the concrete has remained undamaged, and if it is equal to 1, it indicates that the concrete has been absolutely damaged. Well, I will click on OK and OK. In the next step, I'll click on Create Instance, enter the rebar into the assembly section, click on Translate Instance, select Wire Mesh, Done. First, I'll select this point, then this one, and OK. Here you can observe the section where the rebars have been placed. As it can be observed, Cobiax total number is 100 in quantity. And as you observe, some hollow cavities have been created in the concrete slab that can be clearly observed in this manner. The hollow cavities are quite distinct from this view. I'll click on Create Load. Select concentrated force and continue. I'll select this reference point, done, and enter the the force equal to 440,000 newton, and okay in this manner. Maximum of displacement is equal to 4.45 millimeters. And if I show the deformation from here on a 100-fold visual scale, you will observe that the deformation is actually in such a manner. I will select damage T from here, and you can observe the tensile damage of the concrete. The areas marked out with a red color are those having been damaged. Here I will click on Animate. Here you can observe the damage and propagation of crack in the concrete in this manner. Actually, as the amount of force increases, the tensile damage on it will increase as the same, and more areas on the concrete will suffer damage. As you observe, mostly the areas in which there are hollow cavities have been damaged, and this is quite clear in this picture, indicating that the areas in which there are hollow cavities have all suffered damage. Here you can observe the stress contour in the rebars, and also observe that the areas marked out in red color have the most stress in them. Select ODB field output and continue. I'll select unique nodal, then the force is directed at Z axis. Here select displacement directed at Z-axis option, click on edit selection, and select the reference point of this part. I will click on plot. Here two diagrams have been drawn. Here I will right-click on the diagram, edit, select this column, copy and paste that in the Excel software. I will select these two columns. And select this diagram from the Insert menu. Here the force displacement diagram was drawn. As you observe, the maximum of displacement is about 4.08 millimeters.